Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit.
It's the BuckBanditReno podcast. It's the BuckBanditReno podcast. We in this. Yeah, you know what it is. We back once again live on the BuckBanditReno podcast. Yes, episode 93. You know what it be. You already know what it is. I'll be your boy BuckBanditReno.
BuckBanditP.
And it's another hot week. A lot of shit going on. A lot of shit to talk about. But before we get into that, what we going to do, P? What we going to tell them to do?
Subscribe.
You already know. Hit that notification bell.
Uh-huh. You know what I mean? Hit that like button. Uh-huh. Comment. Share. You know what I mean? Make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend.
And tell them again.
And then tell them again.
You already know.
Straight up.
And all the listeners, thank you for listening in. Shout out to all the truck drivers out there that be tuning into us, man.
I know. Appreciate y'all.
Shout out to everybody who watching us on YouTube, man. We appreciate y'all. Make sure you subscribe, man. Get this channel lit. Let's go.
Yeah, man, for sure.
You know what I mean? So we're going to get into the show today because you know why you clicked on it. Yeah, you know what it is, the kid, BuckBanditReno. And I'm here to let y'all know the opportunity is here, man. BuckBandit Podcast Network now is a BuckBandit Podcast Network. So if you out there, you looking to shoot your podcast, you don't got a place to shoot it. You don't got video equipment, video editor. You don't got audio equipment, audio editor, lights, microphones. Don't worry about none of that because we'll handle that. You know, hit me up at BuckBanditReno on Instagram or BuckBandit Podcast on Instagram and find out how you can get your own podcast here on the BuckBandit Podcast Network, man. What are you waiting for? You in the house doing it? You still doing it off your phone? You doing lives? Forget all that. If you in the tri-state area, you in Philadelphia, come get your podcast shot here, man. Hit me up. Once again, at BuckBanditReno on Instagram, at BuckBandit Podcast on Instagram, or you can email me at BuckBanditStudio@gmail.com. Let's get it, man. Mm-hmm. You know why you clicked on it, so we're going to talk about it. Mm-hmm. And we just going to get right into it first.
Let's get into it.
Well, pause, because this person got into something, you know what I mean, allegedly. But, you know, Dwight Howard, man. What'd you think about Dwight Howard and the allegations of him in his boy play, his boy toy, you know what I mean? Text messages out, people asking him questions. He's saying, why my sex life? What does it matter? Does it matter? Yeah, I mean, if you ain't do it, you would say no. You know what I mean? Did you kill that nigga? No. Did you rob that bank? No. Did you have sex with that man? Why my sex life got to be the topic of conversation? What you think?
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of not surprised.
First of all, do you think it's true?
I mean, I'm not. If Dwight do swing the other way or swing both ways, whatever, I'm kind of not surprised. I don't know why. Like, he kind of give me a little, feminine vibe, but
booty guy?
Yeah. 7 foot booty hunter. Yeah, 7 foot booty center. Like, you. Yeah, he got to chill, man. If that's what happened, if that's true, I don't know. He definitely might be banned from the NBA now for real. Like,
what's your thoughts? Do you think that might be the reason Kobe didn't want him?
No, I mean,
that could have played a part.
It could have played a part.
One conversation, Kobe was like, no, this bull is zesty.
This nigga spicy. Ugh, I ain't fucking with this
nigga. He probably said some Diddy shit. Like, yeah, I like how you do that, daddy. We going to go out one day. Kobe was like, yeah, no.
Nigga, what? Nigga, yeah. I mean, Kobe did call him soft. He openly called him soft.
No, like, let's get it. Don't get it fucked up. Dwight should have been in the top 75. His stats that good as a center. But my thing is, you know what I mean? Like, all right, if that's your lifestyle, you might as well come out with it, man. You not in the NBA no more.
Yeah, and you wasn't getting back in for real. If this was your tactic to try to get back in, no, because he wouldn't have did that to himself to try to get back in. But he definitely ain't getting back in now. Yeah, I mean, even if that was, might have been a crazy type of plan. That backfired, because now niggas like, what? If he come in this team, nigga, I ain't playing. Fuck you, though. He ain't signing.
I mean, no wonder he was able to hold Jokic down. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, he was holding
all the
Jokic
tricks
down
of the trade. He pulling all the tricks. Jokic ain't for that shit.
Yo, Jokic is a fucking beast, yo. That nigga.
But, No, on some real though, I like him as a basketball player, regardless of his personal life. But that shit just everywhere, bro. Yeah. That shit everywhere now. And it's like when people ask him about it, instead of just saying no, he deflected. So that to me, that means it's a yeah. It's either no
for sure.
Or deflection.
It's even no or yeah. And you can and say no or yeah, but I could tell how you say no or yeah. If I'ma believe you or not,
and you can't it just say no
if it's true or not. If I no, believe whatever he be I like, believe,
no,
yeah,
no, that's not yeah. true. And they be like, no, no, the way you said no though, no, yeah. it's a yeah.
I was trying to say, and even if it ain't true, and even if it is true or not, it's still to my judgment. And if my judgment, I'm only going by my judgment. I ain't gonna be like, man, listen. Fuck that. There was something funny about that shit. I ain't fucking with. Like, you know what I mean, like, so. I always felt Dwight was on some funny shit anyway. He seemed like one of them, you mean, big play around.
Man, you can't say that. How can you tell? There's so many,
it's certain niggas that when you hear about certain shit, you be like, oh shit, like I'm surprised. And there's certain niggas, you be like, I'm kind of not surprised.
Okay.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like Dwight, one of them niggas, it's like, I'm kind of. Kind of not surprised. He's like, he was fucking with little girls at one point. You know what I mean? Fucking with
so
them
how do you think how you go from all right so girl, like, how do you think he going from high school scouting girls to men? How is that an easy like, oh, I get it.
I don't know. Something wrong with the boy. Like something wrong with it's like something's up with Dwight. He not all there.
I was wondering why he ain't work with the Sixers.
He not all there.
Because he was like a perfect backup to Pauls, to Joel Embiid.
Yeah, he would have been backing him up, all right. But yeah no,
hey,
he,
yo.
it's something with the white. He not all, I don't want to say he not all there, like, but his mentality is like on some young shit. Like, I don't want to say that he doing something malicious.
Yeah, he always been like a big
kid.
But
he on some big, like, it's like he's so gullible type shit. Like he might be like 30, but he's really like.
But that don't
18,
mean
like,
that don't mean you know he gay. That don't mean you know he gay or he doing
he
that
might
shit.
Not
like,
know what the fuck.
It's
he
a
is.
Lot of it's a lot of niggas that's got a little bit more feminine traits. That don't mean they gay. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, is if he is, is nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, like,
actually,
yeah.
that would help him in his push because
if
it's like
transition
he was
out
the first.
League.
Yeah, he was the first. Actual playing gay guy that was actually like could be the, he could be the first gay top 75 basketball player
Hall of Fame, man.
You know what I'm saying? So it's not gonna hurt him to keep it real. I just think you know what I mean, he like both. I think he like both, and he don't want to be looked at a different way, so he just don't want to come out with it. Like, but niggas know already.
Yeah. So
niggas like, oh, that explained a lot. I bet there's a lot of niggas that like that.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm not surprised. Like, I ain't hearing nothing. I only thing I heard, like, he play around in the locker room a lot and this, that, and the thirds. But now that this came out, it's like, oh, play around in the locker room. Hold up. What type of fucking playing around was this nigga
well,
doing in the locker room?
Did you
room?
See that clip of AD you know what I mean? In the locker room and no. the nigga was digging in his butt? He's like, oh, I like it. And then the nigga said, oh, and stop.
Yo, that's what I'm saying.
Bro. Yo.
Like, these niggas is out of pocket.
That's your team, though.
These young boys is out of pocket. I ain't got nothing to do with these niggas is doing.
And since we talk about the Lakers, you know what I mean, the transition from Dwight, because, you know what I mean, shout out to whatever you decide to do, you know what I mean, but hopefully you clear all that shit up and just keep it real. If that's what you do, that's what you do. Ain't nothing wrong with it. You know what I mean? Just do it in the privacy of your own home. And you can do that if you just come out. If you just come out like, yeah, I'm gay, all right, cool.
Yeah.
Next
everybody
week, they on to something
like,
else.
I was just going
to
say, everybody going to be like, oh, shit, the white gay. And guess what? Tomorrow, niggas going to be like, man, I don't give a
they
fuck
gonna
about that
They're
going to
be on to something else. But as long as you keep letting it linger.
They're going to be like, I don't give a fuck about that shit.
It's going to be the topic of discussion as
that
long as you
that nigga wasn't
don't...
getting back in the league anyway.
Yeah. You know what I mean? You already in China making your money, so... You might as well.
And the world's so crazy now, you can fucking fall back in 5 years, reinvent yourself in something totally different and fucking kill the scene and motherfuckers be right back on your dick. Oh, no, I did like him, though. You know what I mean? I ain't never have a problem with it. You know what I mean?
No, it was, like, but that's the thing is, right don't around. Nobody got a problem with his game.
Bro,
it's
yeah,
just
no.
his off-the-court shit that's starting to be, like, very viral.
Yeah.
And instead of him just admitting it or saying no, he's letting it linger. So he one of them type motherfuckers that like playing around a lot anyway. So he could just be playing into it just because, you know what I mean?
You never know.
It could be anything. Exactly. The Dwight Howard has been like a lifelong skit. Like he play around all the fucking time.
Right, that's it.
You
that's
know what I'm saying?
Big ass but kid.
We gonna transition, and I want to ask you a question since we on that topic of your team, the Lakers. Do you think the Lakers can win another title before LeBron retires?
Hell, what?
You think they can get one more before LeBron retires?
I mean, it's LeBron, dog. Absolutely not. They not getting no more damn titles while LeBron. What? It's a wrap, dog. He's done. He said all he want to do is play with his son and then play with his other son. You know what I mean? Like, he just got a finish line. Like, all he trying to do
is play.
Yeah, but
that's like 4 years.
For another four. That's what I'm saying. All he trying to do is play for
So you see how they upgraded their team? Good. Yeah, I mean, they got a real good team this year. I'm not going to hold you.
You seen what the fuck happened on opening night with the Nuggets?
Well, yeah, but
what you mean? Well, yeah,
it's still a chemistry thing because they just got a couple new players. They still don't know who playing
is
where.
The Nuggets still in the fucking Western Conference.
Ain't like they blew them out.
And the Nuggets wasn't even looking good. That's my point.
And
LeBron on minute restriction. The Lakers never looking good. They ain't looked good to
last year, nigga.
They
came back the second half of the year
after the trade, they had to ball their way into the play-in, bro. And then they had to face up against who? The niggas who they played on opening night. Who the best player in the fucking league.
So you going to judge a team off the first game of the season?
I'm just saying,
asked me. That's a new team versus a team that's been together for 3-4 years.
You asked me, that's what I'm saying. So you asked me, what is their chance of winning the chip? Their chances are none as long as the Nuggets
stay the
Nuggets.
That wasn't the question. The question was, once again, do you think LeBron and the Lakers can win another chip before LeBron retires?
Absolutely not. As long as the Nuggets stay the Nuggets, it's a wrap. And the Nuggets not even a better team than the Warriors when the Warriors clicking on all cylinders. The reason I can't say that because I've never seen the Lakers clicking on all cylinders.
I don't know if Warriors going to work with Chris Paul in the starting lineup.
Yeah, he needs some help in that second lineup. They need to put him in that second lineup, and he needs some help.
He could drop an easy dub a game off the second lineup.
Yeah, you know what I mean? That'll work. But no, and on top of that, we not even talking about the East, just the West. Like, it's Lakers right there, but still. And then after that, you got Phoenix. I don't see the Lakers being better than any of them three teams in a playoff series.
Don't forget, the Pelicans was number one before Zion got hurt.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The West is. So you asking me, what is the Lakers? Like, the league is in transition right now. Niggas trying to scramble and get these rings before it's a new regime. And you never know. Like, Zion stay healthy and all that. Fuck around. You never know. But the Greek Freak, he coming. He won another one.
I mean,
Jason Tatum and Porzingis is coming.
Yeah, they look good.
Bro.
They look good tonight.
LeBron, that ain't – who is help?
Even
AD?
Even though it was, what, the Knicks they played?
Like, who is help? Yeah, it was the Knicks. Exactly. Niggas acting hype about the Knicks. If they don't sit the fuck down somewhere. But, dog, who's LeBron help? It's LeBron and D'Angelo. Like
– No, Tareem Prince?
No.
AD?
No.
Christian Woods?
No.
D'Lo? Austin Reeves?
No. That's not better than Curry and Clay, fucking Durant,
not, but
Booker.
But you're talking about on paper opposed to chemistry.
I'm just saying, Joker, fucking Murray. I'm just saying, like, that's.
I feel like anytime you got LeBron on your
team, LeBron can't do it by himself. Like,
AD
he'll
can
go.
Be the best player on the team. It's a chance.
AD, he too. Like,
he
got to
be the best player on the team.
Though. But AD play like a fucking bitch, man. Like,
you know the crazy thing is
he don't play like a big man.
The crazy. Oh, do you think? Oh, you know the crazy thing is, if AD wanted to, he could be a mixture of Embiid and Antetokounmpo if he played like
that. Too soft though.
He
it's too soft. He shoots too many jump shots. I've seen it, and I'm like, yo, he, like, just because you can shoot don't mean you should shoot. Right. He should be taking it to the rack and getting a whole lot of fouls. Like, the reason why Joker is so good, because he not – just because he can shoot don't mean he is going to shoot every time. Yeah. You know, he going to get fouls. He going to get layups. He going to do a hook shot. He going to do up and unders. He going to pass. He going to get bored. Like, he going to block. He going to get steals. He going to defend. Like, AD just one-dimensional. Like, he defend on – like, on when defense, he defend when he wants to. And on offense, he just going to be passive.
He got the potential to be the best, he got the best all-around big man.
Yeah, but it's like
– but he don't – I don't feel like he push it to the limit.
Yeah, he don't play with that sense of urgency. And it's like, Joker play with sense of urgency, and it don't even look like it. Nigga had 29, 13, and 11. You be like, damn, I only seen him score like five times. Like, what the fuck? Like, how the fuck did he do all that? Like, but it's just certain niggas got a knack for that shit, dog. But they looking good. Porzingis and Tatum. I ain't gonna lie. Porzingis and Tatum looking good. I know they was playing the Knicks, but bro, chill.
And I don't know. There's a couple good teams that look good this year. I don't see the Heat really doing nothing this year, but they always sneak up and
because they tough. Got the Bucks. So LeBron and them winning the chip in the next 4 years, not likely, bro.
We still waiting to see what Harden do.
You can't count him out, but I ain't betting on it. And Harden's a bum. Get him out of here. Get him out of here.
He not a bum, but he definitely he definitely don't step up in clutch moments. Like,
you're choking.
And that's something that's salty for me, because I like Harden.
He choked. You know what I mean? He choked. He was supposed to have a chip.
I wouldn't say he choked.
The league could be a whole lot different.
I wouldn't say he choked, because if he choked, that would imply that he tried.
Yeah, he choked. Just like choking. Like, that's. I mean, it ain't like it. Yeah, because he did try. It's just like
he didn't try.
The moment was just too big.
He had
for you.
No the shot moment, attempts in the fourth quarter.
Yeah,
quarters.
The moment just too big for you. But it's like, motherfuckers forget. Like, history is so crazy that unless you seen shit, like, you wouldn't be able to put shit into perspective. Like, if Golden State lose to the Thunder that year, they don't get that first chip. If they fucking lose to the Rockets that other year, they don't get that second chip. And both times, they was down 3-2. Like, game six going, like, both of them times, like, the Warriors wouldn't have chips and other than when Durant came there and then they won. Like, that was, of course, they was going to win that year. Mm-hmm. But them 2 years, they might not have won a chip. They might not have been able to even get Durant. You know what I mean? If they didn't win them last two. Like, a whole lot of shit had to happen for them to win. Like, but hats off to them.
Broke up.
The Thunder, that's what I'm saying. A whole lot of shit might have happened if the Thunder beat them game six in OKC. When they fucking lost in game six and the Warriors go on to win that chip. And then the next year, fucking, they do the same shit against the Rockets, Chris Paul, James Harden, and they was up game six in Houston and they fucking lost and then the same shit happened. Mm-hmm. Like, that's crazy, dog. Like, but shouts out to them, because when they clicking on all cylinders, that just go to show. It's nothing you can do. It don't matter how good your team is. No matter what team. When Steph and Clay and Draymond get that chemistry going, dog, I can't bet against that.
They small this year, so it's like they going to have to outscore Denver.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And that's why I like Denver, because Denver got everything. They got the height.
Yeah, they all around.
And they can shoot.
They definitely all
around.
You
know what I mean? So they going to get all the – like Michael Porter Jr., he going to get like 10 boards a game. Easy. You know what I mean? Like Joker, you know he going to get average more than fucking 10 boards a game. Like, he fucking around average another triple. Like, Jamal, he going to do his thing. Like, and that's what – like, when I watched that fucking opening night game, like, the way – he be torching our fucking guards. Like, the shit not even funny. It's like, dog, foul the niggas. Do something. Like, y'all just letting him just run all over. Run over. This dumb ass. Like, he be doing all that. I'm like, yo, he is cooking these niggas. And even if he miss, it's like just his enthusiasm just going make sure he gonna will himself to. You know what I mean? Like, that body language and all. Like, that shit be mattering, yo. Like, and the Lakers don't got that. Like, D'Angelo, he ain't that for us. Like,
the crazy thing is, when he was in Brooklyn, he was dead.
Right. That's what I'm saying. I thought he was going to bring that.
I thought he was going to bring that from Brooklyn.
I thought he
Brooklyn.
Was going to bring that, but he
it's
ain't
them LA
that.
Lights.
Yo, it's something. That's what I'm saying. And it ain't like you said. It ain't like niggas don't be trying. The moment be too big for motherfuckers. It ain't, like, it's just something about that. Like, Russell came here. Like, Westbrook came here, and it was just, it's too big for him. Like, the LA lights. The lights is too big for niggas. Like, the moment. Like, they don't know what to do, dog. I don't know. Because they don't know how to ball. Like, but that shit is, I ain't saying, like, that shit is difficult. I know that shit difficult, but I don't know, man. They ain't winning it. I ain't
you
got them winning it.
It ain't
happening.
You think?
Too many other. Because
I don't know. You think Bronny going to be like a top five pick, or you think Lakers going
to
be able to get him?
It don't matter. They're going to get him. Whatever they got to do to get him, they going to get him. Because if not, Bron out. So that's the only way I see some shit like that happening. If Bronny go to a OK team, and then, you know, because Bron only going to sign 1 year contracts from now. He ain't. That's exactly. He going to sign 1 year contract just in case some shit like that happen. Then he'll fuck around, go to the fucking Hornets or some shit, and then they fucking win a chip. Now, I can see some shit. That's the only way LeBron will win a chip. He not winning the chip with the fucking Lakers.
With his son,
if
with
he play
OK
with his
team.
Son. If he, you know what I mean, fuck around, go to the Cavs or some shit. And then, like, if some shit like that happened, oh, yeah, Bron going to win another chip. Because it's going to be something where some type of chemistry going to happen. He's going to go with a bunch of young boys, and it's going to
be
his son.
Yeah,
you know I mean? He's going to have somebody with a fucking superstar like Donovan Mitchell who could drop 50 on niggas. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, I can see some shit like that.
And he'll be able
that.
To take less money to go wherever
that's
he
what
wants.
I'm saying. That LeBron will win a chip like that, but he not winning a chip with Lakers. Not this Lakers team, the organization. Like, they would have to get rid of AD, and they ain't getting rid of AD. Like, AD ain't, he can't be the... The only way he could be a second player on the chip winning team is in a bubble. That's the only way, dog. Other than that, it ain't happening, dog. It ain't happening.
Damn.
It ain't happening. Trade AD for Embiid.
No, we don't want
I'm gonna sacrifice my home team for my heart team. You know what I mean?
The only way we would do that is if Embiid said he wanna leave.
Yeah, Embiid out. They said they was training.
No, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, they said they training. I wouldn't be mad, man. Listen, man, the process ain't working, man. The process was
you making up shit. That's false rumors. Don't nobody listen to
process.
That.
Listen, man, I got inside sources that say
you niggas lying.
Inside sources that say you know what I mean Embiid might be you know what I mean.
Oh, anytime you say might, it's a lie.
We might be considering a trade for Embiid, but, I mean,
nah,
we'll see how it play out.
You going to give up the best center in the league?
No. You never know what you can get for him. You know what I mean? It's a bargaining tool.
Whatever you get.
You know what I mean?
Unless they going to give you Antetokounmpo and Dame. Both of them niggas. It ain't happening.
Yeah, Antetokounmpo and Dame? Nigga.
Thanks. Facts.
Yeah, you had to give up the first round picks for fucking next 4 or 5 years with that shit. That'd be retarded.
Whatever. But yeah, shout out to the Lakers. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to LeBron. I actually think LeBron can get a chip one more before he go. I think he can slip one in there.
Whoa.
I said pause.
It still was whoa. I can't.
It was hey, yo.
Oh, my God.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And with that said, since we on NBA, let's stay on NBA, though. And I want to ask you another question. What's the best duel in the NBA right now? Or should we say top three duels?
The best duel. It's definitely Curry and Clay, even though they ain't even, they just so nice. They ain't even won in a couple years.
Clay ain't the same as he been the last couple years, though.
I was trying to say, but they got
a lot of new duels.
It is a lot of new duels, but they ain't did nothing, though. The only duel that did something, probably the best duel right now, is Murray and Jokic. That's the best duel right now. That's my number one duel. The number two duel is probably Durant and Devin, even though they ain't really did nothing, but I still like them this year for some reason.
Mm-hmm.
I like them for some reason this year. And the next duel, damn, they ain't really ball like that yet, neither. All right, I got one as an honorable mention.
No honorable mentions.
No, I got one honorable mention,
bro. No, we doing three.
Ain't nobody even played. Ain't nobody even played yet, though.
Ain't nobody even played together yet.
Who your top three you named these two. Niggas ain't even played yet.
You said KD and Book, Steph Clay, and who else?
And Dame.
One more.
They last because I ain't seen them play yet. Antetokounmpo and Dame. All right. You know what I mean? They last because I ain't seen them play yet. You know?
All right.
But even though I know they going to beast.
Yeah, but from the action I see, my top three duels is going, I don't know if I could put mine in order, but it's definitely.
No, it got to be in order. Say no.
I mean, if I have to, I will, you know what I'm saying? But my shit can go either way. So I say Jaylen Brown and Tatum.
What?
They in my top three.
Porzingis and Tatum better than fucking.
What do you
Jaylen
mean? No,
Brown
he's a third
Tatum.
Wheel. You can't. So yeah, I mean, and Jaylen Brown just got the biggest contract.
He had the biggest points last night.
No, yeah, but he's definitely like a big factor, and he do some of the shit that don't show up on the stat sheet too.
Yeah, he definitely do.
So I put them in my top three. Right. Antetokounmpo and Dame gotta go in the top three. You know what I'm saying? Sure. And I would say Stephen Clay, but I can't say Stephen Clay because they not. I'm right as of right now. It can switch later. You know what I mean? I can't say Stephen Clay right now.
Okay.
Damn. I'm gonna upset a lot of motherfuckers because. What you mean?
You disrespectful.
I gotta say Stephen Clay.
No, I'm just saying, because what you about to say. You about to be real disrespectful.
D-Book and KD.
Oh, I was about to say. If you would have said anything else, you disrespectful. I'm saying.
You know what D-Book I'm saying? Durant, if we talk trio,
Devin,
it's different.
Yeah, exactly. You said duo.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I think my three is a little bit more situated than yours is. All I did was take one out.
Yeah, which was
the best one.
Yeah, no, that was a bad move.
What?
That's a bad move.
Tatum and Jaylen Brown? It's definitely
better than the fucking reigning defending champions? Fuck no.
I'm talking about right now.
Right now, they're defending the title.
Who won last year?
The Nuggets.
Okay, so they're not defending the title.
They are defending the title.
The Nuggets are defending the title.
Exactly.
Now, if you wanted to make an argument for Murray and Jokic, I would give you that. But
what
you
I'm
didn't.
Talking about.
You
did.
Talking about Stephen Clay.
No, I'm talking about Jokic.
No, you's a lying ass nigga.
I'm talking about Joker.
He's a lion hands nigga.
Joker and Murray.
And I think they
and I don't even like them motherfuckers, but I can't fucking.
I can't give them the duel though.
Because they the best.
Because
right
Jokic
now.
Really did it, really like.
No, Murray bust our fucking ass.
Yeah, he did.
He bust the Lakers. And I was watching that whole and I was so pissed off.
But
I,
the Lakers.
After game six, I stopped
only
watching.
Because
when
they
he
had
like
Dwight
50.
Howard. If Dwight, if Dwight Howard wasn't touching niggas in the shower, he would have still been on the team. And then, you know what I mean? Jokic wouldn't have did shit.
Here we go, right there. Okay, let's see what happened.
You already
finally
know what
see
happened.
What these niggas, see what Damon fucking, damn.
The Sixers got Oubre now.
19-9. Kelly?
Yeah.
Little KO?
And you know what happened with Maxie Deuce. Step back on Dame.
Shop, shop. He used the Dame.
We
watched
the highlights. The highlights just came on just now. Sixers right. played the Bucks. So whenever you see this episode, it's probably previously recorded.
Shank, shank, shank.
You know what I'm saying?
B.
I got Maxie on my fantasy draft team, too.
Look at that.
He lost by one. Sixers lost by one.
Dame and fucking Antetokounmpo.
Yeah,
dog.
That's cheating. You can't get them niggas on the same team in 2K.
Right. So how the fuck they pull that off in real life? Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, you know I mean, they got him over there for a bag of chips and a 25-cent hug.
Yeah, but so yeah, man. So the chip is pretty much both of my teams is out. Yeah, you know I mean, you figure you could quarter the market when you get two teams, one on each coast. But both my teams is ass this year. They ain't going to get the chip. They probably make the playoffs, but they're probably losing the first, second round.
Yeah.
Well, that's how it goes sometimes.
All I know is Jaylen Brown and Tatum should be in your top three duels right now.
Yeah, no.
But we'll come back to this list again later. You know what I mean? I bet he'll change his tune.
Yeah, no.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm going to see Porzingis and Tatum.
We gonna keep it moving.
What up, y'all? This your girl, Charlie Baltimore. We down here with my homeboy, Buck Bandit TV. You know how we do. We making them hits in here. Y'all need to come through. I let your girl.
You know what it is, Buckman in the studio. $50 an hour, mix and mastering included. Let's work, baby. And I want to talk about, you remember that old movie, The Wood? Pause.
Pause.
Fucking remember the boy Stacy? You know what I'm saying? I don't know if we talked about this before, but I seen an interview with him when he was saying, like, he regretted, like, doing... that movie, yeah, we did talk about that.
What movie?
He locked down or some shit like that. That movie where he got raped in that joint, he came back and killed the bull. And he said he never even been locked up before he did that movie.
Oh shit!
And then he was like, he said after that, basically him doing that part, he regretted because after that his shit just went downhill.
Oh shit!
You know what I mean, but you ever see that movie? With the boy Lavinio and all that shit.
Lavinio.
The boy Lavinio. Slim.
Boy, black boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely seen that movie. It was him and then the other, like you said, the other boy. Yeah. Stacy. Then they both played in the wood. And it was the other boy. I forget what other boy.
Pause. They both played in the wood. That was crazy.
But yeah, I remember that. That's crazy. He's well, listen, man. That's... He should have fucking read the fine print. He said,
no, it ain't no.
I ain't playing a gay motherfucker. I ain't gonna be in like, you can't, you know what I mean? What you thought was gonna happen?
That like, it was real. That one part where the white boy made him suck him that off shit and shit real. In the joint. Mm-hmm. And he was saying, like, he wasn't
white boy
near
made
him.
His bitch.
Yeah, he was saying, like, he wasn't near him. It was like the boy was standing back that way, but they shot it at an angle. Mm-hmm. And he had to, like, move his head like he was doing that shit. I'm like, yo, I couldn't even fake like that. Because you hear the director, like that.
Sorry, bro.
Yeah, like, hold up.
It's not funny, but I can't.
Yo, he could have said no.
Because it ain't right. That's what I'm saying, dog. Like... And like I be trying to feel sorry for motherfuckers, but at a certain point you gotta be like, yeah, no, I ain't doing it. That's it. I don't need that much. Like if I'm that hungry, nigga, I'm gonna go rob somebody. If I'm to get that fucking hungry. Like what the fuck before I fucking do some shit like that. Like,
he always back there. You ain't
like
gonna
you gotta have morals for some. No, you ain't going. Suck his dick, but I'm gonna shoot it at an angle where it's like, no, no, yeah, no. That's
so
horrible.
It's safe to say that you would have turned down that part.
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm not doing that
because he did go from Paul's the Wood, and he played a good part on there. You know what I'm saying? Like
he was Paul's in the Wood, huh?
Because you gotta Paul's that title.
Yo, that's retarded.
You know what I'm saying? But he played a good role in there. It wasn't for a long time, but it was the role was good. So I would think like he shouldn't have had no problems getting other parts. And I don't know, maybe that was a favor or. But at some point, like, when they ask you, yeah, all right, well, lay over here and put these panties on. You're going to be like, hold up, dog.
I ain't read that in
the script, bro. Like, at some point, you got to be like, hold up. Like, you know what I mean?
I'm not doing that.
So, like you said.
All right, well, you ain't going to get paid. All right, well, yeah, I'm out. Peace. Like, fuck.
Yeah, find somebody else and shoot all them scenes over again.
Yeah, fuck that. I'm not doing that.
But the crazy part is they fuck around and try to make you do that scene last.
Yeah.
So, you already in it.
Well.
Or they make you do it first and you quit it.
Yeah, well, either way, I'm not doing it. No, just put this dress
on. I'm not
going
to be able to do it.
What? No, yeah, I'm cool. I'm out. Peace.
No, no, just look, just put your tongue in your mouth right there to make it look like no.
Yeah, right. No, I'm good.
Pigeon neck. No, he going to be always back there. He going to be making sounds like you doing it.
Yeah.
And you going to pigeon neck.
Yeah, after a certain.
No.
After a certain. Point, like, you look, gotta be like, yo, I'm good.
You fake pigeon necking it from a distance. They shooting it on the
angle.
And this nigga like, yeah. Yeah, nigga. Yeah. Like, yo. Like, no. And you still doing it. And you doing it better.
Yeah,
Circular motion. Circular motion, asshole.
Movie over. Right.
Fuck that.
Movie is over. Doja.
With some real shit. I, in a way, I was trying to feel bad, but I can't. You solidified why not? Like, come on, bro.
At some point, you gotta be like,
yo, no, I'm not doing that. You gotta rewrite it. You gotta stand for something. Yeah.
Like, at a certain point. And if you don't, that's what happened. The world will take the fuck advantage of you. That's for male, female, any fucking body who fucking worship fucking money. Oh, yeah, you worship money? Okay. Well, do what you willing to do for it.
You gonna spread that ass for this cat?
I got some shit for you to do. That's how exactly how they go.
They'll find something for you to do.
Yep. Right. We gonna find something for you to do. You know what I mean? Fuck, that's fucked up, man. That's fucked up that that happened to Bull, man. I hope he, I mean...
Is it?
Bounce back. I mean, it is, but...
It's fucked up what happened after that movie. Is that movie really fucked up? Like, you really picked that part. You read the script. Because they can't just throw that shit in last minute. And if they do, you could be like, no.
He probably didn't read the script, but said he read the script. So either way, he
just to get the part,
right?
Yeah.
So either way, you know what I mean? You fucked. You know what I mean? Literally. So
then they got to the part. He said, I got to do what? Yeah. He said, you ain't read it? Page 862.
Oh, yeah.
Paragraph 16.
Yeah. Uh-huh, yeah. And that's why it was some good fucking acting right there, because it was real. I seen that nigga facing that
joint. Really crying.
I was like, yo, damn, this nigga really got his shit. Like, I started feeling bad. Like, damn. You know what I mean? Like, I forgot I was even watching the movie. I'm shit, man, that's my homie. Why they doing my homie like that?
Yeah, no, Stacy, no. Help him, nigga. Help him, Lavinia.
Like, oh, shit, this is just a motherfucking movie. Damn.
Yeah.
That's some good ass acting.
That shit cut deep.
That was not acting. Because
you think about it, the nigga was his nigga. And then, you know what I mean?
That was not acting.
Yeah.
That nigga.
He was acting. If he was, he was method acting.
That nigga got his pride took for real. Like, that's crazy.
How do you prepare for a part like that? Say you know that part coming.
I don't know. Go hang at a gay bar.
Do you practice like pigeon necking in the mirror?
That's the fuck. I don't fucking know. Fuck.
I couldn't accept that part, bro.
Yeah,
you gotta find something. Get somebody else to do it.
You and me alike, my man. Cause I'm good. Ain't doing it. You need a motherfucking stunt double.
Facts. And damn, I don't know why I ain't talk about this when we talk about the other shit. So we gonna reverse. Cause I told you we was gonna talk sports on this episode. I told you earlier.
What's that?
Do you think Embiid should leave Philly?
Yes, sir.
Don't say just to be an asshole.
Get him mighty.
Don't just do this to be an asshole, bro.
Start the process over. Because the process ain't processed.
I forgot you don't like the Sixers.
Man, listen,
so you
won't
say anything.
When it ain't working, it ain't working. And they jerking.
So who you think they should get for him if they did? And I don't think, by far, I don't think they should trade Embiid. Shout out Embiid. Stay in Philly. You already know Philly all day.
Get Zion or something for him. You know what I mean?
They're not going.
They try to get rid of Zion. Give him Embiid. I mean, whoever else they want, give them some picks and get Zion.
If they want,
get somebody better than Zion.
If they want Embiid, they gotta give a Zion and McCullough.
Yeah, whatever the fuck they want.
Or Zion and Ingram.
Whatever they want, we can give whatever we like. If we give Embiid, that'll be a good trade. I'll take Zion, bum ass. I mean, as long as we get somebody, that'll draw somebody else here. You know what I mean? We still gonna need somebody.
But I don't want Embiid to go though. But we just talking hypotheticals.
He's out of there.
Hypotheticals.
He's out of there.
Who? Where else could you see him going? And for who?
He could probably go to motherfucking. Who else could we get? I mean, it ain't really nobody else. I'm fucking AD, but I don't want no AD. Keep AD over there. I don't want that bum ass nigga. So I don't want no cat. Neither, because he a bitch ass nigga. He play like a bitch too.
If you get cat, you gotta send Anthony Edwards with him.
But that definitely ain't the fuck happening. Yeah. So we can forget that. You can keep Rudy. Yeah, we don't want him neither. You get cat and motherfucking one of the mother bums. Some picks.
Why you keep saying a bum and picks? Ain't nobody taking no fucking bumming picks for Embiid, bro.
I mean, ain't nobody paying top dollar for Embiid neither. Embiid ain't.
What?
Did he play a full season yet?
Yeah.
Last year, couple years, might have been first couple years. Embiid, man. You disrespect. His stock going down, brother. Ben Simmons looking better than Embiid these days.
Yo, you we smoking. I don't know what you smoking, but we it ain't what I got. We got a Z.
Because Ben Simmons Z.
So you got faith in Ben Simmons now?
Nah, see, I ain't say all that.
You back on the Ben Simmons train?
Nah. I was never on the Ben Simmons train.
Yes, you was.
The Ben Simmons train came, opened the doors, and I watched the doors close as it fucking rolled the fuck off. I never was on the Ben Simmons train.
So for you to...
You was always, yo, Ben Simmons. I was like, man,
he was
B,
my man.
Dog. I was like, B. And now I'm like...
I like
please
both of them.
Leave, nigga.
But he was my man.
Unless
he was
we
my
get
homie.
Somebody.
Until he started acting like he don't know me.
Or get rid of Harden and then get somebody nice. Because Embiid can't do it by himself.
Get rid of Harden, get somebody nice, Harden, and then babe, this Ben Simmons last Harden. Year, bring him back to Philly and make him shoot and tell him we're going to trade you if you don't shoot.
Yeah, Ben Simmons ain't coming back to Philly. Ben Simmons will
die. He already said he want to.
Ben Simmons will die if he come back
to Philly. He already said he will want
to. He'll die if he come back to Philly. He bitching. But if he did come back to Philly, yeah, chip. Psych.
All right, but yeah, that's something I wanted to bring up and shit because...
Nothing popping.
I don't feel like Embiid should leave. But if he did leave, I'm thinking like, why would he want to leave? He got it made in Philly. It's his team. If he go anywhere else... It's not gonna be his team. So why would you, you know what I'm saying, give up something that's your whole team and they'll do basically whatever you want to go to another team where they wherever you go, yeah, you can be the bigger player, but it's gonna be somebody else's team already. You know what I'm saying? No matter where you go. You go to Miami, it's gonna be Jimmy Butler's team. It don't matter what the fuck you do. You go to the Lakers, for AD, it's gonna be LeBron's team. You go to Memphis, it's going to be Ja Morant's team, no matter what.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? So, and that's not even the best team.
I don't think
the only team you could go to and it automatically be your team and be like the Cavs or something.
Yeah.
But why would you go to Cleveland? You might as well stay in Philly.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
I mean that'd be better. Mitchell better than any other two he would have here.
Because you're not going to go to the West. It don't make sense to go to the West. You no, throw yourself in heavy competition every year.
Stay in the East.
So where are you going to go in the East?
Yeah, Cleveland. Or they said
if you
New
go
York.
To the Celtics, they got to give up Jason Tatum.
They said New York, but if you go to New York, man, his career is over.
Who's going to – yeah, his career over and who they New York going to give
that's
up?
That's what I said. Niggas
they got nobody
about
to give
Julius
up.
Randle. I said – if
who?
You don't stop smoking crack.
Julius Randle and who?
Exactly. That's what I said. And then who else? Y'all can give up the whole starting lineup and fucking every first
Van
round
B,
pick.
You trying to give
like,
up Julius Randle.
It's nobody
Randle,
on New York.
RJ they Barrett, must be trying Brunson.
To, yeah, like, y'all going to have to give
the
up.
The coach.
All, yeah, right. Exactly. Nigga, Spike
owners,
Lee got to come to at
Spike
least
Lee.
Five games, nigga.
Like, well, he bad fuck? Luck for them, so they can keep Spike Lee. Stay over there with the Knicks, cause I heard ever since Spike Lee been going to the games, they've been losing.
Yeah.
So we don't want. Shout out to Spike. I fuck with some of your movies,
oh,
but
sure.
Don't come to no Sixers games. Stay over there.
Yeah, but I don't know. Embiid is no real place that Embiid could go. That's gonna be fair.
That's gonna be better.
Honestly. It ain't gonna be fair.
It's a grass is greener
Embiid.
On the other side type thing.
Embiid is gonna be Embiid, but if he go with somebody who could drop 50 at any game. I mean, Harden can drop 50. Like, I don't want to, but he ain't did it in so long.
He already showed he could bring players to him. Why would he go to somebody else's team?
Yeah, it don't make sense.
That wouldn't make sense.
It don't make sense, but yeah.
So whoever made that report, lick balls, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
I
want to
see what they can get for him.
And whoever your sources is, tell them niggas, shut the fuck up because they don't know shit.
I'm going to tell them. As soon as I see my sources, I'm going to tell them.
Tell them to shut the hell up. You know what I'm saying? As soon as they be like, yo, how you going to shut the hell up? You know what I'm saying? And I wanted to talk about something else. Since we're talking about sports, we're going to talk about somebody behind the sports, and that's Rich Paul. Yes, and I see some interviews with Rich Paul.
Richard.
And I feel like Rich Paul get a lot of hate. And a lot of people say, oh, he only on because he only get people to his agency and stuff because LeBron. You know what I'm saying? Like, he wouldn't be where he at with signing his people because of LeBron. And what he said made a valid point. He said that that made it harder for him. You know what I mean? Because niggas think he only on because of LeBron. So he don't know shit. So he really had to prove his shit. And like, you know what I mean? And the way he's saying it is like LeBron don't have stakes in the company. I don't think that's true. I think LeBron got stakes. Ain't nobody gonna let you manage them without you having proven to work with millions yet. Even you being his man and not say at least, all right, just give me like 10% of the company. You know what I'm saying? So he probably just gotta keep it on the low right now. But do you think he like the one of the most hated? Because they got like a Rich Paul rule and all that shit now. Where like they making it so niggas homies can't really like, they trying to make it so niggas homies can't manage him. Like you got to be, have an agency thing or go through, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, it's fucking genius. If you ask me, it's kind of like what Floyd did. You know what I mean? Like how Floyd did with boxing. It's like, you know what I mean? It's like, you change, once you, you know what I mean, do something different, you change the game. So, like, do I think it's fair is what you said? Like,
do you think he, like, the most hated agent?
Who, Rich Paul? Oh, yeah. I mean, he the most hated by the system, but he the most loved by the players. And the, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, he one thing I can say is he definitely be getting them players their money.
I was just about to say, you heard about niggas, his last like, who? Fucking couple.
He got how much?
You heard his last couple years, his run in the last couple years? Mm-hmm. Like, he been getting motherfuckers paid. Yeah. Most likely, if they got a lot of money these past couple years, it's because of Rich Paul. Like, in mostly fucking several sports across the fucking, you know what I mean? The sports world, like he really doing his thing, but he really worked his ass off. He really went to school. He really, I mean, like, but I mean, it's more than one way to skin a cat. LeBron probably really not owning this company because it'd probably be illegal. For, you know what I mean? But that ain't got nothing to do with startup money. They ain't got nothing to do with me paying for you to go to school. They ain't got, you know what I mean? So still, I could have Angel invested in this shit. Yeah. And you know what I mean?
That's what I was thinking.
Know what I mean? Like, so I could fucking, this shit might not go to me, but it might go to my kids' kids. You know what I mean? Like, it might be in a trust somewhere for my kids' kids. So
I don't think it would be,
you know what I mean?
I don't like, think it would be against the rules for him to, for him to own stakes in his agency.
Yeah,
not against the NBA rules.
Yeah, I was trying to say, it probably would.
It's niggas who don't have agents and let their parents fucking.
Yeah, right. That's what I'm saying. But it's because the whole thing is taxes. That's what it all boils down to. That's why a lot of niggas get caught up. So if your mom, it just means you got to file your taxes differently. You know what I mean? Because you got to report everything on your like, niggas don't tell motherfuckers that. Everybody want to get rich and get all this money. You will get ate up by taxes and medical bills. You know what I mean? Like, them two things right there. So that's why motherfuckers don't want to say, I'm an owner of this, or this, that, and the third, because you're going to have to fucking report your profits, your loss, your margins, your expenses, every fucking thing. You know what I mean? Like, so nigga be like, man, fuck it.
Or maybe, like, in a Rich Paul case, say if LeBron did invest in, and they just say he didn't. It's just to make his man look good.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I would do the same shit.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't own nothing of that shit. That's all him. You know what I mean?
Right.
And he did my finances right, and he got his other clientele based off of him doing my shit right.
Yeah.
I just gave him the platform because I'm the biggest star.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, if you manage the biggest star bread and he coming out a billionaire, niggas going to be like, oh, you got an agency? Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm going to fuck with your agency.
I was just trying to say, and that's probably why they did it like that, because it's like, I'm not going to have stake in this company or my name anywhere on this company. You know what I mean? Just because you still my homie, so when you do get your shit up and running, or you know what I mean, is good, I'ma definitely put you out there because you my man. So I can't have my name on the company because it's gonna be like a conflict of interest. You know what I mean? But I don't know. Like, LeBron, he's smart as shit. It's a reason he the first billionaire why he's still playing ball. Like, he figured out a gray area, he was like, out. I'm a fucking work in this gray area like how these motherfuckers do, and they going to think all they want to think, but it ain't going to be no proof nowhere about whatever the fuck they think. And that's smart as shit. Like, LeBron the GOAT, man. I mean, Rich Paul, he most hated by the system. Most loved by the players. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I fucks with that. Like I said, he got everybody that fuck with him got a check. Mobile, not maybe check. Not everybody, but let's say his rate could be like 90%.
Yeah, niggas got
that's paid. A high rate. You know what I mean? So shout out to LeBron for having faith in his homie. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Rich Paul and Mav Carter for keeping that shit going, man. For because sure. You definitely on the bigger stage, bigger light on you. You fuck it up, it's out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
And them niggas been on their job. So
facts.
Salute to them.
Facts. And I want to talk about this last thing. We got to talk about it one more time, hopefully, because it's a big topic, man. And DJ Envy, man, he's... It's looking like real estate RICO, him and Caesar.
It is looking
like. We talked about it last week.
It is looking like it. I didn't see it. I went further digging ever since you said it. It's looking like niggas about to get pickled.
He really trying to separate himself from it. Mm-hmm. And the dude Caesar came out with a video talking about how, like, it's funny how we partners. I don't just do business. I have partners. We partners. Like, no, nigga, we going down, nigga. No, I ain't going down. We going down, nigga. Both of them.
Yeah, so, I mean.
So DJ Envy trying to back away, and Caesar pulling right back in. What you think?
Yeah. It's like, every time I try to leave, something keeps pulling me back. I don't know, dog. It's looking real spooky. You know what I mean? Happy Halloween, niggas. It's looking real spooky.
Yo, I seen some shit where they were saying that's why Angela Yee knew this was coming. That's why she left.
That's why she was like, you know what? It's too much. Because where it is, like, because you know they bring motherfuckers on the Breakfast Club who be trying to put motherfuckers on game. Where it is, they had a couple motherfuckers on there who turned out to be scammers and shit. So Angela, and that was when Angela Yee was on there. So she, like, that must have been her cue. Like, you know what?
You know what I mean? They offered me a show. I'm out of here.
I'm out. Fuck that. These niggas on some other shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. Because she totally left. She could have did both of them.
Yeah.
She totally left. Like, fuck y'all niggas.
Yeah, but yeah, I mean, if Envy knew, which I don't know how he didn't know, he, like, he, like you said, he trying to back out, but he did say they was partners. He definitely used to always say that.
Videos is coming out where he's showing people the cribs and all that.
Right, that's what I'm saying. So,
you can't act like, oh, no, I ain't know. I just collected money. Yeah. I ain't know. Yeah. Nigga. Who
even
gets
if you
involved with a business?
Even if you didn't know.
No, you didn't know.
But I was just trying to say, you still guilty. So, like, they using your crib to fucking smuggle drugs, but I didn't know. Nigga, you're still getting booked. It ain't you didn't know. So, either way, you done, dog. You collected the money. Oh, no, I didn't know where the money was coming from. I just collected. Either way, you're going to either give it back or get booked. Like, that's how it's going to
fucking you still going to get booked and you got to give it back.
I was just trying to say, or the double bubble. Yeah, get booked and give it back. We're going to take it right out your fucking bank account, your assets, whatever you got to sell.
Freeze all your shit.
Yep, real shit. Yep. So, that's how it go, man. If you really scammed the motherfuckers, dog, that's fucked up, dog. Like, and it's looking like motherfuckers is going to jail behind some shit. So, yeah, done. Don't feel sorry for you. That's fucked up. You already got money. Like,
that's what I was thinking. I'm like, because he had to know what was going on. Because ain't nobody with a couple $100,000 or a couple million going to invest in anything without investigating what they putting their money into. I don't see nobody doing it. I know if you say, yo, Reen, I got these couple houses we gonna flip.
I need a couple $100,000.
Yeah, all right, let me see the paperwork, bro. I'm gonna read that shit. It's a couple $100,000, nigga.
Exactly.
It's not
no,
$10, $20.
Exactly. Ain't $2 to go to.
You call me, Ed, yo, I need you to invest in this shit. Yo, you got a bean over here.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not even thinking about that shit. If it do something, it do something. It don't. It's $100,000?
I need to call lawyers. Yeah. I need something gotta get got. Like, hold up. I need paperwork. Yeah. I need contracts. I need receipts. I need everything that comes with that, nigga. I need conversation. You gotta buy me dinner, nigga. where we meeting
if
that?
We gonna be partners. I need taxes for the last couple years.
I need all kinds of shit, nigga. You not about to play me on my bread. You need $100,000. I said, Nigga, here, go this check, nigga. No, $100,000,
and I'm gonna get how 1.5 and how long? Oh, all right, here. Like, no, that's not how I'm about to play.
Exactly.
Cause, oh, is he like money hungry? Yeah. Or is he believing in his homie? I don't know. Mm-hmm. Now it's like he ain't his homie though.
Right.
Now it's like I don't really know him like that. I mean, I know him, but I don't know him.
Right.
That's the vibe he's giving off.
Yeah, that's how niggas do when
they don't want to get caught up.
Mm-hmm. I know him.
Caught up.
Know him, man. Like,
caught up.
Straight up. So
what you think? You think it's jail? Yeah. You think it's jail for Envy?
The verdict is
changed. That's it for the Breakfast Club?
The verdict has came in and the verdict has been changed to guilty.
You think that's it for the Breakfast Club?
Yep, they done. That's why Charlamagne been, doing his shit on the side. Just in case anything failed, he like, fuck it. I got other shows, other podcasts, other shit I'm doing.
They gonna fuck books, around and get joined in Jess.
Yeah. Right, she gonna be the last one there.
Well, her and Charlamagne?
Yeah, Charlamagne will be there too. that's Envy done. They calling for it. I ain't mad. I ain't want to believe it.
I ain't want to believe it either, man.
But
like,
it is,
bro, you already got bread. You literally didn't even have to get in business with him. You got your car shows. You already scamming off them joints.
Right.
Getting other niggas' cars and charging niggas just for having niggas
to bring
their cars.
Right, to bring their car there. How you going to charge me to fucking, and I'm the attraction, motherfucker.
But yeah, man. Hopefully he don't go down. But if he did steal that money, hopefully he pay back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, get them people their money back.
Give it back to him, dog. You don't even need it.
Right.
Badass
dude.
You know what it is, the kid BuckBanditReno.
The boy BuckBanditPit.
Here from the BuckBandit Podcast. And we here to let y'all know, for all y'all entertainers, upcoming promoters, fucking entrepreneurs, y'all, mean, we got your own clothing line. No matter what you do, man,
try and get
on the BuckBanditReno Podcast. And if you want to sponsor on the BuckBanditReno Podcast,
get your brand out there, seen by the other motherfuckers, you know what I mean? Get your shit popping out here.
Let's go, man. Hit us up. BuckBanditStudio@gmail.com.
But, it's been another great episode, man.
Pleasure.
Shout out to everybody who been tuning in every fucking week.
Appreciate
y'all. Shout out to all the truckers listening in. Shout out to all the artists and entrepreneurs and everybody that tuned into us. Family, friends, whoever watching us, man. Shout out to y'all, man, for tuning in every week. Keep watching us, man.
Appreciate it.
Make sure you hit the subscribe. Don't just watch it. Share. Make your own clip. Post it, talk shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Don't just say, oh, yo, I know you when I see you. Say that when I'm not around.
Exactly.
When you post that clip.
Exactly.
Oh, this is my man.
Tag us in and we definitely repost an A.
You man. Already
we
know.
Just tag your boy.
You know what I mean? I see y'all in the stories watching.
You already know.
I need to see y'all in the views and I need to see y'all in the listens. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
So I know you be riding around, listen to the podcast. You know what I'm saying? You ain't doing nothing else.
Right.
You don't listen to the radio. You listening to the same songs every time you ride.
Right.
Tune over to Buck Bandit Podcast, man. Hey, Siri.
Right.
Yeah, search Buck Bandit Podcast. You feel
exactly.
me?
Exactly.
So, you want to tell them anything else before we get out of here?
Man, you already know what time it is. Tap in with your boys. Like he said, man, subscribe, share, tell a friend to tell a friend.
Subscribe.
And then tell them again.
A motherfucking man.
You already know, man. Another hot episode. See y'all next week.
Episode 93.
93.
You already know what it is.
Buck.
Yo, yeah, this is a crazy ass killer. You know what I'm saying? This is Hoover from Silicon Valley. This is Dwight from Dodgeball. I'm on the Buck Bandit Podcast. Chris Williams. Check it out.
Turn me up a little bit. I'm tryna be richer than rich.
Hey. Hey. Okay, bitch, let's see this party. All of my niggas retarded. Pull the shit sweeper and take out the garbage. Michelangelo, I draw like an artist. Bitch, I'm the shit smell like somebody toilet. Pockets on curry, I guess that I'm ballin'. Trap phone ringin', guess somebody callin'.
Yeah, I guess somebody callin'.
Ayy, I move this shit by the low. I do this shit by the cold. Ayy, I spit this shit with my bro. Real niggas know, yeah, that's just how I go. Ayy, bosses, they do what they want. You niggas do what you told. Ayy, if you call me in, it ain't about paper. The answer is proper, so no. Nigga, don't ask me for shit. You wasn't there from the rip. Bagging up, working the whip. Mind only focus on making a flip. Call up P and tell him, nigga, we going legit. Tunnel vision for the grip. All these things I'm at a miss. I'm making up for this shit. Yeah, I'm making up for this shit. Won't catch me loving no bitch. Won't catch me trusting no bitch. They'll set you up for a lick. Ayy, don't worry about me. Ain't stop when they made jewels. The stock, it came with the kid. Ayy, I got more money to get. Trying to get money like rich. Trying to be richer than rich.
I gotta be richer than rich.
Okay, bitch, let's see this story. All of my niggas retarded. Pull the shit sweeper and take out the garbage. Michelangelo, I draw like an artist. Bitch, I'm this shit smell like somebody toilet. Pockets on curry, I guess that I'm ballin'. Trap phone ringin', guess somebody callin'.
Yeah, I guess somebody callin'.
Ayy, I move this shit by the low. I do this shit by the cold. Ayy, I spit this shit with my bro. Real niggas know, yeah, that's just how I go. Ayy, bosses, they do what they want. You niggas do what you told. Ayy, if you call me in, it ain't about paper. The answer is probably no.
Ayy.